In the last video, we made this animation where we learned how to make the dog walk across the stage and the butterfly fly with its wings flapping. Now let's make this into a nice animated story. So it's up to your imagination what story you will make, but in the story that I am creating, I want that the butterfly should fly the way it is flying right now, but the dog should enter from this side of the stage and they should meet in the middle, and then they should have some sort of a dialogue, which is a story. So first, let's figure out how should we make the dog enter from this side and facing the other way, because we want the dog to come from this side and then it should be facing the right way, not that it is walking in reverse. So let's see how we do that. So in the code that we are writing for the dog, if you go to motion and if you scroll down, you have this command which says point in a particular direction. And if you click here, it tells you where the sprite will be pointing. So we want to flip the dog. So if I make this angle minus 90 degrees, right now it is plus 90, I'm making it minus 90, and I'm going to put it here so that I'm saying that when the green flag is clicked, the dog should point in minus 90 direction. So let's see what happens. If I click, so then the sprite of the dog, not only is it facing in this direction, but it is also flipping vertically. We don't want that. We want that the sprite should flip only horizontally. So let's see how we achieve this. So again, in motion, if you scroll down, then you have another programming block called set rotation style. And if you click on the drop down, it has left to right, don't rotate, all around. And what we want is that the dog should only turn left and right, that is horizontally and not vertically. So let's take this command, let's put it here. And now we are saying when the green flag is clicked, set the rotation style of this sprite of dog to left and right. That means it will only flip horizontally, not vertically. And then set the direction as minus 90. So let's run this program. If I click, now my sprite of my dog is pointing in the right direction. And finally, all we want is we want the dog to enter from this side of the stage. So like I told you, you just place the sprite exactly where you want it. And then if you go to parameters, you just note down the value for x and y coordinates. So here we have x 194, y minus 122. So we go back to the program. We say x is now 194 and y is minus 122. And now if I run the program again, we have what we want. We have the butterfly coming in from the left side of the stage and we have the dog coming in from the right side of the stage and pointing in the right direction. And the next thing we want is we don't want them to fly across the screen. We want them to stop somewhere in the middle, both the sprites, and then have a dialogue which will be our story. So for this, all we need to do is reduce the number of repeats that we have. So let's say the dog right now is 30. So let's make this 20. And the butterfly is 40 times it's repeating. So let's make it half, around 20. And then let's run the program. So now we have these two sprites and they are coming here. Maybe a little less. I think maybe the dog should be lesser and then we can have a dialogue. So let's just change the dog's value. So let's say it's repeating only 15 times. Let's run the program. Yeah, so that's about right. And now we can have the dialogue. So let's have some dialogue. So let's have the butterfly say something to the dog and the dog react, and that will be our story, a simple story. So now when we have come here, we are saying that the butterfly, when all of this has happened and the butterfly has reached where we want it to reach, then it has to say something. And when we want a sprite to say something, we go to looks, and from here we have two commands: say hello for a particular period of time, which is 2 seconds by default, or just keep saying something like say hello. So here we want the butterfly to say something for a specified period of time, and maybe we want this the butterfly to say hello dog, and we want it to say for 2 seconds. So let's run the program. So that our the two sprites meet, the butterfly says hello dog, and let's just make a quick story here. So it will say hello dog, then it will say let's say the tick, you know, dogs have ticks, the tick is going to bite you. Okay, so let's see what happens. So we have, when we run the program, our sprites walk across the stage, the butterfly and the dog, and then the butterfly says hello dog, the tick is going to bite you. And now we want that the dog should react. So in M block, when you want to tell one sprite to act when the other sprite has done something, so for example here, once the butterfly has said the tick is going to bite you, now the dog has to say or do something. So to tell the dog that now it's your turn, what we do is, you know, like you've heard of walkie talkies, when you in movies you must have seen that when you talk on walkie talkie, when one person is stopped talking, they say over, and over means okay, I am done, now it's your turn. So equivalent of saying over, it's your turn, if you go in events, in M block you have this command which says broadcast a message. So broadcast a message basically means that it's going to tell all the other sprites that I am done, now it's your turn. And we are going to say, if you click the drop down, we are going to make a new message and we are going to give it some title. So let's just call it message 1, and we are going to say, so once the tick, once the butterfly has said the tick is going to bite you, it's going to broadcast a message called message 1. And now in we go to dog, and in dog's programming we say in the events, we go and we scroll down, and here we get another fresh command. So this is like, we have this event trigger which is when green flag is clicked, we have another event trigger which is when I receive a particular message, and we just said that, you know, the message is message 1. So now the dog sprite is going to wait, it's going to execute all these things, and it's going to continuously listen for this message. And as soon as this message is received, that now we can tell the dog to do something. So let's say the dog then says something like, oh no. And then let's run this program and see. Yeah, and I think when the dog is saying, oh no, let's the expression of the dog change a little. And if you remember, when we had got this sprite out, there was another third costume for this dog sprite, which we had deleted. And I think that sprite will look very nice here when the dog says, oh no. So let's bring that sprite back. And to bring that sprite back, I'm going to click on this new costume within dog. And then if you scroll down, you will find all these costumes that you can use. So if I go to animals and I scroll down, I have the dog and I have all the three animations for the dog. These two we are using for the walking cycle, and this is the one we want. So I select this, I say okay, and then in my programming, I'm going to say when I receive this message, say oh no, and also change the costume. So let's say here we want the costume to be the third costume, 2C. So what we want is the costume should change first and then the dog should say, oh no. So let's run the program. And if I start it, oh, so anyway, there's something funny happening here, which I'll just explain, but let's see what happens. So it says, hello dog, the tick is going to bite you. The dog is saying, oh no, and it has the expression, but the problem is that now in the walk cycle where we had used the next costume command, all the three costumes are being used. But for the walk cycle, we only want costume A and costume B to be used. So how do we fix this? We go back to programming, and here instead of next costume, which will bring all three costumes, we have to make some change. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take away this next costume. I'm going to delete this programming block. I'm going to go back to looks, and I'm now going to specify which costumes to use. So I'm saying move 10 steps, switch the costume to costume 2A, then wait for 0.3 seconds, and then go back and switch the costume to costume 2B, and then wait for another 0.3 seconds. So we are getting, slowly we are getting there. We have the dog walking. We are not using the third costume. So the walk cycle animations are correct, but the animation is not very good, and you know, we can improve the walk cycle. So let's go back here and let's make it like this. Let's say it'll move. I'm just making the entire cycle half. So I'm saying move 5 steps, then move 5 steps, wait for 0.3 seconds. So let's say start with costume dog 2A, move 5 steps, wait for 0.3 seconds. Then again, move, and let me also lessen this. So let's say, let's make it 0.2, because we are now adding 2 weights. So I'm kind of making the cycle exactly half, if you understand. I'm saying switch to costume 2A, move 5 steps, wait for 0.2 seconds. Then again, let's make it half, move 5 steps, switch the costume to dog 2B. Actually, I should put it the other way around. I should say first switch the costume, then move 2 steps, then wait 0.2 seconds, and repeat this whole thing 15 times. Let's run this program. So it's better, and we can, if you want, we can, you know, make it even better, you know, change the number of steps and all, but I think it's looking fine. And it's going to say, oh, the tick is going to bite you, and you know, the position of this is slightly different, but we can fix this. So let's go back here. So what we want is, if you see this program again, see the dog is in this 2B when it finishes. When it finishes the walk cycle, watch, it's in 2B. We want it in 2A so that it looks like it's relaxing. So to do this, what we are saying is that after all this is finished, the dog should be in 2A costume when the walk cycle finishes. And then what will happen when I say, when I receive message 1, switch to dog 2C, and here also we'll have to rectify the exact X and Y coordinates. So let's run the program again. So now we have the dog walking, and we have the butterfly, and they meet, and then the butterfly says, hello dog, the tick is going to bite you. And the dog says, oh no. But here the dog has gone a bit too low. We want the dog to be here. And like I explained earlier, when you want to know the exact X and Y coordinates, you go to parameters, and from here you just note down X and Y. So X is 52 and Y is minus 69. So here I'm going to go to motion, and I'm going to say X is 52 and Y is minus 69, and let's run the program. One of the problems with this animation is that when the butterfly stops, it also stops flapping its wings, which is not real. A butterfly, you know, to stay in the air has to keep flapping its wings. So to make that happen, so what we can do is, where it stops flapping its wings, we can create another event. So the new event here is that we are going to broadcast another message, and this message we'll call it message 0 because it's coming first. So we are saying broadcast a message 0, and what we want is that within the butterfly, when we receive this message 0, we want to create another flapping of the wings animation. So we are just going to duplicate these two blocks, and we are going to put them here and back where they were. So what's happening now is that whatever we wrote earlier, the program, all that is going to be executed, and once the loop is over, it will broadcast a message 0, and the message 0 will be received by the same sprite when I receive message 0, and then it will just start the walk cycle, and we need to put this in a forever loop. So what we are saying is keep doing this costume change forever after this part is over. Okay, so let's test this. So we have the dog walking, we have the butterfly flying, they meet in the middle of the stage. It says hello dog, but now see, the butterfly is constantly flapping its wings, which is how it should be. So I hope you understood this broadcast message concept. It's a very powerful concept to tell all other sprites when one sprite has stopped doing something, or you know, has reached a certain point, and we now want that other sprites or the same sprite should do something else after that point in time in our program. So now the last thing we will do is add some background music to our animation so that it becomes more interesting. For this, you can add background music on any sprite and it will run. But just to show you that all sprites are programmable in mBlock, I'm going to choose the background and I'm going to add a music loop which will constantly play in this. So I'm going to go to event, I'm going to trigger, I'm going to select the when green flag clicked programming block, and then I'm going to go into sounds. I'm going to drag out some sound, let's say play sound pop until done, and then if you click the drop down, you have this add new sound, because pop is just one, like a pop sound, which is just like a special effects. But what we want is a background song which will constantly play, or a background sound which will constantly play. So I'm going to say add sound, and then we have the sound library, and in the sound library, if you go into loops, you have all these different loops. So let's say some interesting one. I'm going to choose this dance around sound. With the sound selected, I'm going to click on this check, on this tick icon, and I'm going to say okay. So it's saying play sound dance around until done, and what we can do is to make sure that we have this sound playing constantly in our animation, I can go to control and bring out a forever loop, put the sound inside the forever loop, and now if I play this animation, so I hope you like this animation and you will try to make more animated stories based on all the programming concepts you have learned in these videos.